it is.
She's right.
Thank you.
Well, it's their own fault for saving it. And then...
Professor Weasley?
Somewhere away from prying eyes.
Forgive me, the headmaster stopped me and I... Merlin's beard! I see you've wasted no time. Well done. Shall we?
Off to you, Professor. What is this place?
This is the Room of Requirement. It only appears when one is in real need of it. Ordinarily, a student might stumble upon this room entirely by accident. If ever. I'd only planned to suggest to you how to find it by walking past that bit of wall, focusing on what you need. But you've managed to reveal the room on your own. While I'm here, we should take advantage of the moment. Now, where is Deke? He must have sneaked past and gone ahead.
Deke, Professor?
The house elf I was speaking to in my classroom your first day. Thought he might help you use the room once you found it. There's no chance I'm clambering over this mess. This presents the perfect opportunity to teach you Evanesco, the vanishing spell. You can cast Evanesco to vanish certain objects, such as these chairs and other things here in the room. I suggest you practice the wand movements first, then you can clear the chairs away. Splendid. Now, cast Evanesco on those chairs. Excellent work. You'll note that you are now in possession of Moonstone. We shall discuss its uses later. Let's move on. Where in Merlin's name is that elf? Is that... goodness. My old school bag. I wondered where that had got to.
Revelio.
Can't believe it's still here. I'll just take a quick look at this. Give you an opportunity to explore on your own until we locate Deke.
Yes, Professor.
Dear me. Can't you keep it down?
Accio!
Hope this isn't as precarious as it looks.
An intruder! Stop them! No, not... that's not helpful, you worthless pile of tin!
Revelio!
How does anyone other than a house elf manage to get around in here? What was that? Was that a golden snitch? Accio!
Perhaps you should summon your wits and find out.
I hope that house elf can find us in here.
Yikes! Careful!
Huh? Oh, there you are. Wait right there. Deke will come to you. Hello.
Ah, Deke, we've been looking for you.
Apologies, Professor Weasley. Deke was looking through some of what's appeared in the room since Deke was last here. Is this the student?
Indeed it is.
Deke is honored to meet you.
Deke has been a friend since I was a second year. We discovered this room together. I mentioned you to Deke. We believe that you might be able to benefit from this room like I did. Deke, would you be so kind?
Of course, Professor Weasley. The Room of Requirement will always be equipped for the Seeker's needs. It's unplottable, so won't appear on any map. Most happen upon it by accident, if ever. Deke seen students in need of an extra file for potions stumble upon the room filled with them. You seem to have accessed it in its form as the Room of Hidden Things.
I was thinking about needing a place away from prying eyes. Brilliant.
Oh, that explains it then.
What I need specifically is a place where I can catch up on my schoolwork without distraction.
Well then, the room can provide you with precisely that. Now, it's time to focus on what you need. Just close your eyes. Imagine the room precisely as you need it. The room will do the rest.
Yourself quite a canvas to work with. I look forward to seeing what you do with the space. Ah, and it seems the room has provided you with a desk of description. Excellent. It can identify unfamiliar items of clothing. One should always understand the effects of anything in which one is clothed. You You'll find plenty of items of clothing that need to be identified. The desk will be an invaluable resource.
I imagine the desk of description will come in handy.
It will. I hope you'll take advantage of it. Now, I'll give you a brief lesson in conjuring. The room might not provide everything you need on its own.
Conjuring?
Yes, the magic of creating or conjuring objects. I'll teach you. Very good. When conjuring more complex objects, you'll need what's called a spellcraft. Spellcrafts are like recipes. They list the ingredients or resources needed to conjure a particular object. You should have acquired some for a potion station and potting table from tomes and scrolls in Hogsmeade.
I did. Where can I find the resources I need?
While resources such as moonstone can be obtained throughout the Highlands, it's much safer and easier to purchase them. They can also be collected by vanishing objects in the room, such as the chairs you vanished earlier. In fact, you should have enough resources for now.
I see. Can I regain resources by vanishing something I've already conjured?
You can indeed. Quite perceptive. Why don't you give it a try? Go ahead and conjure the potion station and potting table. You should find both familiar since they'll resemble the ones you've already used to study magical plants and brew potions in class. You can use these whenever you need to brew potions or grow plants. Presuming, of course, you've collected any seeds or potion ingredients you need in Hogsmeade or outside the castle grounds. Deke will be here to answer any questions you may have. Do not underestimate his insights.
Can I use this type of transfiguration magic outside of the room?
Conjuring and vanishing are strictly forbidden elsewhere in the castle. We've charms in place to enforce that. It would be exhausting to reverse the errors in both judgment and magic. But the Room of Requirement has its own rules.
Can you tell me a bit more about Deke?
He's been at Hogwarts longer than I have, and seems to know its every nook, cranny, and secret. We discovered this room together when I was a student. Deke has had a good deal of experience, both here at Hogwarts and at a previous post. I shall let Deke tell you more when he's ready, but again, you would be wise to listen to any suggestions he may have.
I will be sure to speak with Deke if I need anything. Thank you.
Good luck. I shall linger a bit longer in case you'd like to learn another transfiguration spell for use in the room.
I'm ready for the next lesson, Professor.
Very well. First, you'll need to gather some moonstone. You can acquire it by vanishing items here in the Room of Requirement, or you can gather it carefully outside of the Hogwarts grounds. Return to me once you've gathered enough, and we shall begin the lesson.
Hmm.
I have the moonstone you requested, Professor.
Good. Then we may begin your lesson. You can conjure more than potions and herbology tables. Conjuration can be used to decorate this space to your liking. Why don't you try it on the walls and floor?
I would like to teach you Wingardium Leviosa. It can be used to levitate objects for a short time. Once you've completed a few prerequisite tasks, do see me after class.
Shall we move on?
I've conjured everything I can. What's next, Professor?
I think you're ready to take on alteration. The altering spell will allow you to customize any conjured item. You can change the colors, patterns, and styles of your furniture to suit your taste. Let's get started, shall we? Watch closely as I demonstrate how to perform the altering spell. Just aim your... any conjured item and perform the altering spell to customize it.
Thank you.
Nicely done. Now you're ready for something a little more advanced. You can use the altering spell directly on the room's architecture. Try these new designs on the floor or balcony. Try aiming at the floor or at that balcony. From a bit of ambiance, don't you think? Deke, would you mind?
Of course, Professor Weasley. Professor Weasley showed Deke this bit of magic some years ago. Deke thinks you'll enjoy it. Come and talk to Deke when you're ready.
Professor Weasley said I should ask you about changing the room's ambience?
Of course. What sort of overall look most appeals to you?
I would like the room to feel as if it's being lit by the moon.
Oh, sounds perfect.
Quite a difference. Of course, you needn't keep this style if you don't like it. You can always ask Deke to change it back. Now you have learnt a good bit about alteration.
Thank you, Professor. The room is full of possibilities.
Indeed. No matter how much time I spend here, the room always manages to surprise me.
Did that happen?
The room equips itself to your needs. It must have sensed that you needed more space to practice spellcasting. If you'd like to customize the space further, you can use these spellcrafts. You'll find more of them both inside and outside the school.
Thank you, Professor. I shall keep an eye out.
Good. I'll leave you to it. This is your space now. Use it wisely.
I'd like to ask you about changing the room's ambience.
Of course. What sort of overall look most appeals to you?
I'd like the room to be warm and comfortable, as if I'm floating inside a mug of butterbeer.
Oh, sounds perfect.
Thank you.
I'd like to ask you about changing the room's ambience.
Of course.
Actually,
It's me, Gareth. Do you have a moment?
Were you calling me, Gareth?
I was. After you helped me with that fupa feather and potions, I reckoned you might be just the person I need. You see, I have an idea for a fizzing, Wisby-inspired beverage, but I'm missing a key ingredient.
You and your concoctions. I don't know how you come up with these things.
It's a gift, truly. So, I suspect the key ingredient in fizzing Wisbys is dried billywig stings. I heard there's a store of them in Honeyduke's cellar. I'd get them myself, but my Aunt Matilda has her eye on me. Thinks I need to focus on potions class for a while, not for my own brews. I was hoping you could follow a secret passage to Honeyduke's cellar and grab a few dried billywig stings for me.
Sounds simple enough. And who wouldn't want to go to Honeyduke's?
Ah, brilliant. Thank you. The passage is hidden behind the statue of a one-eyed witch in the third floor corridor. Just tap it with your wand and say, Descendium.
Couldn't you have someone buy the dried billywigs things?
They're not for sale, and you never know when the cellar's going to be locked. So, the reliable way in and out is through the secret entrance.
Are you asking me to steal from a shop?
Goodness! It's not as if I'm asking you to rob Gringotts. Honeydukes is more than enough, and I only need a few. It's a sweets ingredient. They won't be missed. Trust me.
I'll see what I can do, Gareth.
Fair enough. You shall be the first one to taste my newest brew if you can be of help. Perhaps I can convince a meat to help me with my potions homework. Get my aunt to loosen her reins a bit.
I'll need to get those dried billywigs things for Gareth if he's to finish his latest concoction. A one-eyed witch statue shouldn't be too hard to find. This looks like the right statue. Now, what was the password? Descendium! Goodness, who knew this was all down here? Revelio! A lift. Must be how I get down. Looks broken, though. Repairer! Revelio! That seems to have done the trick. This castle will never cease to surprise me. so. Revelio.
Going to have to get past this.
Levioso. Revelio. Repairer. Levioso. Confringo. Revelio.
Make it across.
Repairer. Leviosa.
Something is getting in the way of that platform.
Accio. Leviosa.
That did the trick.
Revelio.
This must be the way. I need to find a way to open that gate.
Confringo!
Something smells sweet. Must be close to Honeydukes.
Revelio.
Honeydukes. I can smell the chocolate. Now, where would I find the dried billywig stings for Gareth? Have the dried billywigs things. Now back to Gareth. I can only imagine how his new recipe is going to turn out.
Ow!
Wouldn't be surprised if Professor Bin.
Hello, Gareth. I have those dried billywigs things.
You got them!
Incredible.
Happy to help. Here you go.
This is brilliant! Can't wait to get started. Thank you again. I'll let you know when I've brewed my first batch of fizzing whiz beer.
Thank you. Shane Bardolph thought dark magic was the answer. I reckon Rookwood's played a hand in...
Excuse me, did you say something about Bardolph Beaumont?
I did. I don't think we've met. I'm Dorothy Sprottle. I was just worrying about Claire Beaumont's brother, Bardolph. Only he's gone missing. Rumour is he was seen in the forest practising dark magic. Saw him myself near some ruins with Rookwood's lot I did. I fear he got himself into trouble with the Ashwinders, especially if he made them a promise he couldn't keep. I'd help search for him myself, but no one will risk encountering Ranrock's loyalists. They seem to be everywhere.
Why would Bardolph want to get involved with the Ashwinders?
Oh, he had a terrible run-in with Ranrock's loyalists. Changed him. He vowed never to feel powerless again. I think he sought the Ashwinders out to learn their secrets. Victor Rookwood, at least, seems somehow immune to Ranrock's loyalists.
Do you think Bardolph may have simply run off?
No. Bardolph's run that shop with Claire his entire life. He'd not give it up for anything. He swore he'd be back in a fortnight. My instincts are that he's been held captive, or worse.
I can certainly look out for him.
Any help would be appreciated. You might speak to Claire first. Perhaps she has some insights that I don't. I can tell you that Bardolph was last seen in the forest wearing a particular woolen jumper, one that Claire knitted herself. Claire will be at her shop if you'd like to speak with her.
Upper Hogsfield is being terrorised by Ranrock's loyalists. It's not right.
Madame Beaumont, might I speak with you?
Yes. What about?
Mrs. Sprottle told me a little about your brother's disappearance.
Oh, dear Dorothy. She'd go looking for Bardolph herself if she could.
She mentioned dark magic and even the Ashwinders.
Despite my repeated warnings, Bardolph's been experimenting with dark magic near the edge of the forest. I thought perhaps he'd get it out of his system and it would gradually stop. But then one day, he didn't come home.
Could Bardolph have run off?
No, he'd never leave me here alone. He did speak of going to talk with Victor Rookwood. That worries me almost more than his attempts at mastering dark magic. Rookwood is as dangerous as Ranrock, in my opinion.
Is there anything your brother took with him that might help to track him down?
Only his satchel, journal, and a woolen jumper I knitted for him. That's all I can recall.
I'll let you know if I see or hear anything about him.
Thank you. How kind. I'd be so grateful to learn where he is. I know in my heart he's out there. Do be careful.
What do you have for sale?
Bardolph, where are you? I'll not give up hope. Marvellous. I can always... Ranrock's loyalists are a menace. What can be done? Thank you for passing through.
I couldn't help but overhear. Did you mention Ranrock's loyalists?
I did. Never imagined they'd act this deadly. I'm Claire Beaumont, by the way.
Nice to meet you.
Ranrock and his followers have set up camp here. No regard for our beloved hamlet or our livelihoods. Ruthless. My brother Bardolph dared to stand up to them and ended up in St. Mungo's. I'm simply at my wit's end.
How did your brother Bardolph end up in St. Mungo's?
Bardolph had spent the entire day handpicking herbs and roots for us. When a group of Ranrock's lot appeared and demanded the harvest for themselves, Bardolph refused. In their anger, they hurled him against a rock and robbed him. The moment he left St. Mungo's, he vowed revenge. I worry he may be dabbling in magic that he will one day regret.
You said Ranrock's loyalists have set up camp here. Where, precisely?
To the south, across the river. Last I heard, there were several loyalists in each camp. I won't go near them.
Why don't you simply leave the area for now?
Upper Hogsfield is my home. Baldolf and I grew up here. No, we are standing firm. Once my brother returns, then we shall decide what to do next. He's gone to seek Victor Rookwood's advice. I didn't approve of that idea, but perhaps in the end it will help.
I'm unfortunately quite familiar with Ranrock's loyalists. Perhaps I can do something.
Much as I would love to be rid of them, I wouldn't want you to risk injury, or worse. Please be cautious.
A map. I wonder where it leads.
Be alert. Ranrock's loyalists are unpredictable and violent.
It seems as though things are getting worse. Best be on my guard. Who lived here, I wonder?
How nice of you to stop by. You will regret coming here.
Potatoes!
Right now to be worried about you!
Confringo! No!
I won't rest until you're not quiet enough.
Stupid one!
How nice of you to stop regret. One less human to worry about.
Incendio.
I will make you pay. I won't rest.
Ranrock has fooled you all to your demise.
One camp down, one more to go. Both camps cleared. Madame Beaumont will be glad to hear that. Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this.
Very generous, thank you.
I do miss the bustle of business.
Hello, Madame Beaumont. Good news. I was able to clear out Ranrock's camps.
You cleared them out? How?
I managed to catch them off guard.
When my brother returns, this news will mean the world to him. You saved our hamlet, my young friend. This will not be forgotten. I fear for other hamlets, truly. Ranrock and his lot are unlike any goblins I've ever seen.
What do you have for sale?
What are you looking for exactly? Thank you. Sincerely. Thank you for passing through.
I should investigate. Revelio. This mentions in theory, and something about it being Bardolph's turn next. An entry from Bardolph's journal. He overheard whispers, a plan, something to do with him. Revelio.
I do hope my brother is all right.
Madame Beaumont, I do have some news of your brother.
Oh, please tell me he's safe.
I'm afraid he's joined the Ashwinders and has no interest in returning.
What? No, this can't be. He was seeking their advice, that's all.
I'm truly sorry. I wish it had been better news. I wish you well, Madame Beaumont.
What more could I have done? Oh, Bardolph!
father.
Lumos. Lumos. Enchanted candles. Wonder where they're heading. The candles seem to be leading into the Forbidden Forest. Treasure must be nearby. I suppose a picnic in the Forbidden Forest. Treasure hunting suits me.